exclusive hot new
high school holla.
Here it comes.
Holla, Chicago! Stephen Spoon Ramsey welcoming everyone from Chicago and all surrounding areas to the best place in Chicago for high school sports, the H2S2 High School Holla Sports Show. We have debuted already one of the best post-game shows in history for high school sports. Right here, our post-game edition of the H2S2 show, as we bring you post-game interviews with coaches and players from games played this week around the Chicago Public League. And we return back to the Washington Park area to visit a team that has gone now 3-0 for the season with another shutout win. Joining us once again this week for another Dyett Eagle victory is head Eagle himself, Coach Reed. Coach, you guys are building it up, man. Great win this week. 48-0. You guys are doing it.
Yeah, man. Good. They're doing a good job. So I'm very proud of them. They're stacking the wins, not playing down, and just, you know, handling business the way they're supposed to. So I'm proud of them.
Well, Coach, tell us about this win. You guys took on the Richards Warriors, and your team performed well. And it looks like you guys are getting better and better and better every week.
Yeah, I would say I got some strong seniors leadership that's on the call now. They just, you know, they come in, day out and work, and I contribute a lot of that to them. So, you know, they a lot of coaches on the field as well. So, I mean, I contribute that to the strong senior leadership. And, you know, they're not going to take nothing for granted. So they're taking advantage of the opportunity in front of them.
Well, Coach, it's time. Let's talk and introduce this week's Dyett Eagles shining stars. Who we got joining you this week, Coach?
I got a couple of my seniors. Consider them captains, my seniors on the board here. Rashawn Davis, very vocal leader of mine. I think he's one of my eyes on the field. He challenges our players. He also challenges coaches as well. I think he's a very strong leader. Saint Gates, a running back. DB, I think he's, like I said, when I seen him, he got off on him yesterday. So I'm very excited to get those highlights out there on him. Caylon Hall, senior as well. Very strong receiver. He had a really good game yesterday. And a strong safety. And then Kengston, our linebacker and running back as well. So very strong senior leaderships on here.
Well, it's time to talk to these seniors and the shining stars this week of the Dyett Eagles. Let's start off, man. We got to rattle off some numbers here because you guys got some stats coming. Let's start with Caylon Hall-Rattler. 5 receptions, 110 yards, 2 touchdowns. Ran an interception back for a TD. A 3-touchdown day. Congratulations, Caylon. It got to feel good when you're getting home to the end zone like that.
Thank you.
We also got Saint, 10 carries, 150 yards rushing, 3 touchdowns. Saint was blessing them all day long in the end zone. Good job, Saint.
Thank you.
We can't forget Kingston, 7 carries, 80 yards, touchdown. And then on the other side of the ball, 4 big tackles. Kingston, good job.
Thank you.
And the man that Coach calls a vocal leader, 7 tackles, 1 forced fumble, 1 fumble recovery, and a sack. In other words, he stayed in the other team's backfield more than he did on this side of the field. I like that, Rashawn. You got to feel great.
Thank you. Yeah, it felt great yesterday.
I want to start off with you, Rashawn. You got 7 tackles, a forced fumble, a fumble recovery, and a sack. Out of all of that, which one did you enjoy doing the most? The sack, the fumble recovery, or the forced fumble?
I would have to say, after all of them, Yeah, I think I enjoy getting the sacks the most. I mean, the fumble recoveries are good, and, you know, the fumble, forced fumbles, you know, they help the team out. But, you know, the sack is for me, you know. I got the sack, you know. That goes for me. So, yeah, I think that's my favorite.
Hey, Rashad, ain't nothing wrong with being selfish, baby. It's okay. That sack is just for you. You earned it, and we're going to highlight that. I like that a lot. Caylon, I want to talk to you, man. A three-touchdown day along with your teammate, Saint. Caylon, when you guys are putting up numbers like that, it's kind of hard to beat these Eagles, isn't it?
Yes, I say it's kind of hard to beat us when we all got our game together and we all work together. You know, we've been working. It's been a weird offseason, and for us to, like, gel together how we do, you know, it's kind of – it's, like, awesome, I say in a word. But, yeah, when we're together and everything's working, I don't think we can be stopped.
And Kingston, I got to give you the microphone next, man. You got 7 carries, 80 yards, and a TD to join your 2 classmates in this scoring spree. We're going to call it that. How does it feel to get your stats up there too, man?
Man, it feels great that I could be able to bring something to the team because as it was mentioned before, we're family, so we move as one. So if somebody contributes to the team, somebody right got to go right behind if we contribute something else to it.
Saint, 150, $150 for you, man, and 3 touchdowns. Coach says he was very proud to see how you progressed in this game. How does it feel to also see the end zone?
It feels great. Like, I'm always enjoying scoring. I love that I can help my team, like, any way possible. And I love that the way my team, we share the ball. Like, Kingston go get it, Caylon go get it, we all go eat. We don't worry about who eating because we all go eat. We're just trying to win.
Hey, when you look at a shutout win, it means all aspects of this team was gelling. Coach, what part of this team in these past 3 weeks have you seen excel in each week?
Man, I'll say our defense, man. Our offense, you know, we feed off our defense. Our defense picks the energy up. You know, defensive coordinator, Coach Williams and his staff, they do a good job getting the guys ready. So I love to see our defense out there, man, shutting guys out and just setting us up. And I think our offense feeds off that. We kind of started off slow yesterday in the first quarter. A couple turnovers and just some, you know, miscommunication. But, you know, our defense did what they were supposed to do, did what they've been doing the last 3 weeks. And just seeing them progress and confuse the offenses and see them puzzled, that's been a good look. So
I want to start with Kingston on this question for the players. What's left? I mean, what else do the Dyett Eagles have to show people in the next few games? What else do you guys got to show? We're going to start with you, Kingston.
Well, this is our senior year, so we got to go out making a statement. In each game, we got to come even harder than the previous game before. So people may think it's not much left, but it means a lot for us to get this far and not lose a single game. So it's still a lot left for us in the end game.
Rashawn, when we talk about, you heard Coach, the defense, what statement is the defense telling the rest of the Chicago Public League?
We making a statement, you know, we here to stay. We up there. We should be up there, you know. We shutting out these teams, you know. We letting the league know that we're here.
I like that. And Saint, I got to ask you, brother, you guys are putting up points every single week. How does it feel to show the younger guys after you what Dyett Eagles football is all about? How is this success teaching those younger guys?
It's just showing them that, like, we better than where we at, basically. Like, this football team as a whole, the commitment we make, the commitment the coaches make, the players make, like, if we really put a heart into it, we can be better. And then the stars limit is everything.
Caylon, you talked about it. I want to get your player perspective from it. This pandemic, it's been pretty painful for some of us as getting prepared for games week in and week out, and even preparing to start this season, how have you guys met the challenges of this pandemic? And still, what do you contribute to the success? You guys are undefeated at 3-0 thus far.
We all want to, you know, get to the next level. We all want to, like, make a statement. You know, us being undefeated so far, showing that we can overcome adversity. So, you know, I mean, pretty much it. Like, overcoming adversity. Because with a weird season, not having all our four games and stuff like that, a limited time to practice, you know, that's pretty good that we're undefeated. So,
well, I got to give each of you, we're going to start with Caylon. With all the support you guys are getting at the Dyett Eagles virtual cheering squads, who do you guys want to give holler out to that's been supporting this team, that's been supporting you throughout your 4 years at Dyett? Start with you, Caylon. Who you giving holler out to?
Well, first I'm going to give it to, you know, my family and my coaches. And, you know, everybody that's been supporting me throughout my whole high school year career, you know. And I also want to thank God, you know, because, you know, without him, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be, like, healthy. You know, I'm healthy. I haven't had any injuries and stuff like that. So, you know, without him, I wouldn't be the player I am, the person I am today. So, those would be the people I want to thank.
Kingston, who are you giving big hollers out to, man?
I personally like to thank both of my parents, especially my mother, for being able to take me along this far. And then I would like to also thank the coaching staff for bringing us together, for bringing this family even closer than what it's normally been, and bringing us to the point that we are thus far.
Saint, who you giving big hollers out to?
Of course, family and all of that, but I'm going to thank some person people out there. Big boss, thank you, Mr. Kelly. He always had our back right inside Dyett School. And I'm going to shout out EB, a former player at Dyett. I just want to shout him out. He was a big leader to me back when I started football for Dyett.
Rashawn, who you giving hollers out to, brother?
Definitely going to have to shout out both of my parents, you know. They're the one who put me in position to play football. You know, I've been playing football since I was 8 years old, you know. They've been pushing me this far. And, of course, I want to thank my teammates and my coaches for organizing us and, you know, pushing us out every week to play a great game. And yeah, that's what I want to thank.
Coach, I got to ask you, Coach Reed, you got this team flying high. What's the ultimate goal in this season for the Dyett Eagles?
We just tell you what's in front of us, playing the schedule we got. So, I mean, we talk about conference championships, and that's what we've been aiming for since we started working out, so since I got over here. So we stacking the week, taking 1 week at a time, and our ultimate goal is a conference championship. So finish out strong, 5-0, and send the seniors off right.
Well, Coach, next week, your opponent on the schedule, the Little Village Phoenix, looking for their first win. What do you know about your opponent, and what type of game do you see happening?
I don't know much. Just from, you know, I haven't seen them. I planned on taking a look at them today and seeing what we got ahead. And I just expect my guys not to do the same thing last 2 weeks, not to take the gas, not to take the pedal and the foot off the gas. Don't play down and just do what they need to do. So that's what we expect.
Coach, I know you have a long list of people that you like to thank and give big hollers out to. And I'm just gracious that you're back on this week. Finish out your list that you didn't get to say last week. Who you giving big holla out to?
I'm gonna give it to the team this week. I'm giving it to the team. I think, like I said, they fighting through some things, and you know, we're not the biggest group. So, and I think they playing, they giving it all. So I'm giving it to the team.
And this week we roll up north to the north side of Chicago and visit Chicago Academy High School, home of the Cougars, who are still searching for that first physical win after a tough loss, 22-12, in a cat fight with the Noble Pritzker Jaguars. Joining us this week as a first-time guest of the show is Cougars head football coach Anthony Dotson, whose Cougars are playing some tough football despite the record. Coach, talk about this team and talk about its effort this week.
Okay, well, this season is their first time having me as a head coach. The last two seasons, I was the assistant head coach. So this is the first time me, you know, just being over the team. So they're learning from me. I'm learning from them. So we have to remember as well, we had a short time to prepare for the season. We only had about 3 weeks to get ready for a season. So, you know, me being a new coach, them getting back on the field after 1.5 years because of the COVID pandemic. So we just had to, you know, get it going really fast. But they all caught on along each game. We're getting better and better. So we're just trying to get that first win before the season's over.
You know, with all the adversity that you guys had to go through, how does that help build the character of this ball club?
Rambo.
Well, I feel they're used to it. The last few years, this school has never been known as a football program. So we're just building up, you know, trying to get the players mentally stronger and physically stronger, you know, to change the culture of the football team and the tradition and just break a new path.
Well, Coach, you got two of the shining stars here with you today. Introduce these two young men and tell them how they've been a part of this culture at Cougars football.
Okay, well, I have Hector Ramirez. That's the running back and linebacker. He's a junior, great work ethic. He's been playing football. Well, these are both players who played the longest amount of football. They've both been in pads since they were children. So I would call them basically the veterans on the team because our team, we only have maybe 3 to 4 that actually grew up playing football. The rest of them really pretty much started playing football in high school. So when it comes to uplift or just teaching their teammates something, I'll go right to these guys. And Nathanial Gayles, he's a senior. He's the linebacker and safety as well and wing back. Great monster when it comes to defense. He gets to every play. You know, I'm pretty much every play is going to be assisted tackle by him because he's going to get that every time. So, and Hector on offense, that's the main person who gets the ball to, and he does something with the ball every time.
Well, let's meet our shining stars. We got Nathanial, we got Hector. I want to just give you guys an opportunity first. Tell the listeners and the viewers who are watching this today what class you represent. And again, how good does it feel to wear that Cougars jersey? I mean, you guys are playing tough.
It feels great. You know, I'm class of 2022. I'm a junior. You know, it feels good to be out here, you know, part of like this podcast right here. You know, to express how I am or, you know, show what I can do on the field and out the field.
Same. I'm class of 2021. It feels good to be on this podcast as well. First post-game interview feels crazy.
Well, I want to talk to you guys. I mean, let's start with you, Nathanial, the senior. Hector, we're going to talk to you next year as a senior, but right now we're going to give Nathanial his senior props right now.
Yeah.
So let's talk to you, Nathanial, the senior. 13 tackles this week, 4-4 loss, and 1 forced fumble. I got to ask you, man, even in a loss, which felt better? The 13 tackles, the forced fumble, or the 4 for the loss? Which of those felt better?
I'll say, I'll probably say like the fumbles, because we need any opportunity to get the ball back, anything. So just – I was really hungry, man. I was desperate to get that ball. So I had to do everything for my team.
I like that. I like that. Doing it for the team. You got to like that, Coach. Doing it for the team. Hector, we can't leave you out, man. You put up some big numbers. 30 yards rushing, 1 touchdown, 91 yards receiving and a touchdown for 121 all-purpose yards, 2 TDs, and you too on the defensive end. 10 tackles, 1 for a loss. Hector, you're on both sides of the ball as well. Which one do you like better, the one that's putting up touchdowns or the ones that's tackling for losses?
Yeah, it's hard to say. I mean, I love tackling. I love, you know, I'm hungry to get that ball, but I'm also hungry to get them touchdowns. I would say, you know, getting them touchdowns because we need to put some points on the board, you know, to help my team and, you know, get that win.
I like that. Now, this team hasn't got this first physical win. You know, you guys, I understand, have a win by a forfeit, I believe, but not the first physical win. Talk about what motivates this team, guys, to keep going out there and working hard.
I would say. Go ahead, Hector. Are you good? Go ahead.
I would say what motivates us is, you know, trying to like prove ourselves to like, you know, our school, you know, to like our staff, you know, try to prove us that we're like, we could be a football team, you know, we could change how we are. We could change the past couple of years, how the football used to be, you know. I think that's our mindset is to, you know, to always do it our best, always, you know, try our hardest and like to change the culture in the school.
Nathanial, what about you, man? How does this help you guys continue to motivate the younger guys? This is your senior year and you're mm-hmm. still out there gutting it out, playing hard on both sides of the ball. As Coach just explained to us, you're from one end of the field to the other. You're going to be a part of every tackle and every play. How does this help you motivate these guys to finish the season strong?
Helps me motivate them by just being there for them and then just trying to coach them as well. Like, we got Coach Dotson here. He helps us motivate, like, everyone on the team just by, like, his speeches, his coaching, and everything. And so that – inspires me to, you know, teach them as well. And I just want to be there on the field and just guide them. I want to lead them.
Well, we always give our guests on the show an opportunity, as we say on the show, to give big hollers out. I want to give you these two young men, starting with the senior. Nathanial, who would you like to give a big holler out to? The Cougar fan base, your family, your friends, that's all been supporting you, man. Who you giving hollers out to?
I would say my mom, because she basically got me into football and everything. She's been there since day one.
You know, the coaching staff are here, my teammates, my family, you know, they're always, you know, on my like side over here trying to motivate me to do better. I appreciate them.
I like that. Coach Dotson, I've asked you, we talked about it briefly in the beginning about the pandemic and how this has affected these guys. How are you keeping this thing flowing in the midst of all that you guys had to face this year?
Basically trying to pound in a whole summer worth of stuff in 3 weeks. So since the fact, you know, usually you have like 2 to 3 months to prepare for the season, we only had 3 weeks. So a lot of cardio, a lot of bear crawls every day. They do that maybe the first hour of practice, is trying to build that muscle endurance and opening up those lungs, because they haven't really did nothing physical in the past year plus. So basically just trying to pound in so much work in a short period of time to prepare them. But in my opinion, you know, win or lose, these guys, you know, they get better every game. You know, they don't give up. You know, some of them even don't get out, and they don't cry about it, don't complain. They stay in. They're hungry to win. The first game, you know, they did the best they could. Last year we lost to Marine 56-0. This year we lost 6-0. We stopped them from scoring the first three quarters. Our defense did the same thing they did this past game. Same thing, just shutting them down the whole time. And the difference with this game, we put points on the board. We were winning at half, 12-8. But you can tell by the second half, we got real comfortable. We thought we had the game already. So we made small errors, and that's how we ended up losing. But I feel like from learning from these first two games we actually played, I feel like we should be fine next week to get our first win for them.
Well, we ask you, you already introduced it. Next week, you guys got the Foreman Hornets. What type of game do you expect, Coach?
I expect that we played them last year. I don't remember the exact score, but I think we lost by one touchdown. Foreman is a good school. They're down the street from us, you know, maybe half a mile. So they're a close school to us as well. So basically just trying to, you know, just fight to show who's going to end up being the best school on the Northwest side. And, you know, so when it comes to a lot of teams are actually in our area, from Stuy-Mass to St. Pat's to Taft. It's a lot of programs in the area, Schurz. So, you know, we're just trying to, you know, get our name at this school as well, because it's a lot of tough programs in the area. So just trying to put Chicago Academy on the map with our first win.
Coach, we got to come up with a name for this game. I mean, you guys are too close. This is a great friendly rivalry. We got to call it the Wild Wild Northwest Battle or something. We got to come up with something for this game, man. It's too close.
Yeah, we're going to think of a name. We're going to think of something, yeah.
Hey, I've got to ask Nathanial and Hector. Nathanial, this being your senior year, and as we just talked to Coach about the pandemic, has this pandemic and all that you guys had to do to prepare to play this season, giving you a newfound respect for football?
Yeah, it's been kind of hard with the pandemic going on, because we had to literally take precautions for like the safety of others, and just we had like little practice, like we had like little time to practice, and we just had to do everything we can to just keep going and like working hard.
And Hector, the same sort of question, but you have another year to play. How bad do you want this for the guy next to you, Nathanial? How bad do you really want to end this strong for him?
I want to end it really good. You know, I want them to, you know, have a senior, you know, a really good senior year of football. You know, since it's their last year, you know, I want to have a good time, a good experience. You know I have one more year, but I also, you know, look out for my teammates, you know, make sure my senior QB, you know, get his passing yards, you know, Nate gets his tackles, you know, we all do good for like the seniors. You know, I feel like we progress every time, and you know, that's the important part. And I'm always there for my teammates.
I love it. I love it. Coach Dotson, we gave them an opportunity. We got to give you the same. There's a lot of Chicago Academy Cougars out there cheering you guys on virtually, supporting this program. Who you have to give big hollers out to?
I would say to the admin, when it comes to the principals, they support the team. They make sure, you know, they're there for us. They support us, whatever I need for this team. They make sure they have it for me. Another shout out to my assistant coaches, Coach V and Coach Leonard. They both, I asked them to join me last minute. You know, they were okay with it. You know, they helped the kids, taught them the whole offense concept of the team. So without them, you know, we wouldn't be having the success we have right now. And last, I'd like to give a shout out to the team. You know, they, you know, me being a tough coach, you know, it's something new to them. So they just, they endure a lot. You know, I put them through a lot, but, you know, they don't complain. They come to practice every day. They show up. This is one of the biggest teams we ever had in the past couple of years. We started with about 38. Now, right now, we have about 30. You know, usually it always was between 15 to 20 players every year, but we have a pretty big team. So that's good, because the future, you know, the only thing that's going to happen, the team's going to get bigger and stronger every year. So I'm just proud of these guys for believing in me, sticking with me, not giving up, and just being ready to change the culture of this team.
Well, Coach, man, we enjoy having you guys. Coach Anthony Dotson, Nathanial, Hector, our shining stars of the game, thank you guys for joining us this week on the H2S2 post-game show. I feel it. It's coming, guys. Trust me. We have had much success in helping people get over that hump. So I believe you guys are definitely going to do it. Good luck the rest of the season. And when you do, come on back to the H2S2, baby.
Yes, we'll be back next week. We'll be back next week.
Yes, sir.
We would like to thank the coaches and all of our shining stars of the game who joined us this week. Remember, you can catch the H2S2 High School Holla Sports Show on all of our social media sites. That's YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. You can also subscribe to the H2S2 podcast on iTunes, Google Play, and SoundCloud simply by searching Urban Fieldhouse Media. Go to our website at urbanfieldhousemedia.com, where you can listen to some past shows and segments on the Urban Fieldhouse Media website. Always remember, God loves you, and we do too. I'm Stephen Spoon Ramsey saying, holla at you next week on the H2S2 High School Holla Sports Show.
High School Holla.